Here the question is, we need to find equation of tangent to the hyperbola which makes an angle pi by 4 with the transverse axis. Now first we'll write this equation in standard form. So we'll take 16 common, we'll write x square minus 6x, and here we'll take 25 common, we'll get y square minus 4y, and this is equal to 356. Now we'll complete perfect squares. So we'll add 9 and subtract 9, and here we'll add 4 and subtract 4. So we'll write 16 x minus 3 square minus 25 y minus 2 square, and 16 into 9, 144, 144 plus 100. So there'll be 44, and 356 plus 44 is 400. So this value will be equal to 400. We can write equation to this hyperbola as x minus 3 square upon 25 minus y minus 2 square upon 16, and it is equal to 1. Now slope is 10 theta. So that means value of m is simply 1. So now we can write equation of tangent as y, which is y minus 2 equals m, m is 1, x minus 3 plus minus under root of a square is 25, m square is 1, and then minus b square. So we'll get this equation as y minus 2 equals x minus 3 plus and minus 3. Now we'll take plus sign, we'll get this equation as y equals x plus 2, and if we'll take minus sign, we'll get this equation as y equals x minus 4, and the only option present in this case is this option A, which is y equals x plus 2. Now here the question is, we need to find locus of point of intersection of two tangents to hyperbola which makes an angle 60 with each other. Now we know that equation of tangent is given by y equals mx plus minus under root of a square m square minus b square, and let the point of intersection be alpha comma beta. So we can write this as m alpha minus beta whole square, and it'll be equal to a square m square minus b square. So we can write this equation as alpha square minus a square m square minus 2 alpha beta m n plus beta square plus b square equals 0. Now this quadratic equation will have two real roots m1 and m2, and it says angle between tangents is 60 degrees. So it simply means that tan 60, it must be equal to m2 minus m1 upon 1 plus m1 m2, and tan 60 is root 3. Now we'll square it, we'll write m2 minus m1 whole square, and it'll be equal to 3 1 plus m1 m2 whole square. Now we can write m2 minus m1 square as m1 plus m2 whole square minus 4 m1 m2, and here it will be 3 1 plus m1 m2 whole square. Now we'll put the value of m1 plus m2. m1 plus m2 is sum of roots, so it will be 4 alpha square beta square upon alpha square minus a square whole square minus 4 m1 m2 will be beta square plus b square upon alpha square minus a square, and here it will be 1 plus, and then again beta square upon b square by alpha square minus a square whole square. Now here alpha square minus a square whole square will cancel, so we'll write this result as 4 alpha square beta square minus alpha square minus a square into beta square plus b square, and it'll be equal to 3 times alpha square plus beta square plus b square minus a square whole square. So we simplify this, we can write this as 3, and alpha square is x square and beta square is y square, so it'll be 3 x square plus y square plus b square minus a square whole square, and l be equal to 4. Now alpha square beta square will cancel, so we'll get a square y square minus b square x square plus a square b square, and that's your option number C. Now here the question is, two tangents to hyperbola having slopes m1 and m2 intersect the axis at four concyclic points. We need to find the value of m1 into m2. Now suppose equation of tangents is given by y equals m1x plus under root of a square m1 square minus b square, and let the other tangent be y equals m2x plus under root of a square m2 square minus b square. Now for this tangent, the point of intersection of x's will be, so we'll put x as 0, we'll get y as under root of a square m1 square minus b square, and we'll put y as 0, we'll get x as minus under root of a square m1 square minus b square upon m1 comma 0. And in the same way, for the second tangent, it'll be 0 comma under root of a square m2 square minus b square, and will be minus under root of a square m2 square minus b square upon m2, and it is equal to 0. Now if these point of intersections, they are concyclic, they lie on a circle. Now this point is say x1 comma 0, and this point is x2 comma 0. This one is 0 comma y1 and 0 comma y2. In a circle, these two chords, they intersect at origin. Then if these points are concyclic, we can simply write x1 into x2 must be equal to y1 into y2. Now x1 into x2 is under root of a square m1 square minus b square upon m1 into under root of a square m2 square minus b square upon m2, and it must be equal to y1 into y2, which is a square m1 square minus b square into under root of a square m2 square minus b square. Now I'll cancel because m cannot take the value plus or minus b upon a, because in that case it'll become asymptote to this hyperbola. So from here, the only result that we'll get is the value of m1 into m2 must be equal to 1, and that is the answer to this question. Now here the question is, if the line 2x plus y equals 1 is tangent to hyperbola x square upon a square minus y square upon b square equals to 1, if this line passes through point of intersection of nearest directrix and the x-axis, then eccentricity of the hyperbola is. Now we can write this equation as y equals minus 2x plus 1. So here the value of m is minus 2 and value of c is 1. Condition of tangency is c square equals a square m square minus b square. So it'll be 1 minus 4a square minus b square. Now this line, it passes through point of intersection of nearest directrix. So that means it'll pass through AE comma 0. So we'll put x as a upon e and y as 0. Then we can write 2a upon e and it is equal to 1. That is, value of e is 2a. Now we'll try and find value of e. Now in this equation, we can write this as 1 minus 4a square, and b square is a square into e square minus 1. So we can write this equation as 1. We'll take a square common, and then it'll be 5 minus e square. Now we can write a square as e square upon 4. So it'll be 4 e square into 5 minus e square. So we can write this equation as e to the power 4 minus 5e square plus 4 equals 0. So we'll get e square minus 1, e square minus 4 equals 0. That is, the value of e is either 1 or the value of e is 2. Now since this is hyperbola, value of a is simply 2, and that is the answer to this question.